What's up, y'all? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're a returning subscriber, and if you are new, welcome. My name is Jay, and I'm about to give y'all the tea today on how I gained 10,000 followers in 2 months. So without further ado, if you want to see the tips and the tricks, keep watching. If you've been following me for a while, you know that I have my business, Lavishly Loves Cosmetics. We sell cosmetics, etc. June, we hit 10K followers on Instagram, y'all. In April, we had like 330 something followers. So we gained 9,500.
Yes, sir.
I'm about to show y'all what I did to get that many followers, and I'm also gonna tell you the tea. So the first thing that I'm gonna tell y'all, like the most important thing that's more important than all of these tips that I'm about to tell you, is that you need to know who your audience is. So if you do not know your audience, like, you're gonna have a hard time reaching them. So I say this to say, if you've done like a follow train, or if you just started following random accounts, they're most likely not gonna be interested in whatever you're selling. You need to know your audience, engage their interests. So if you're following 16 to 20 year old women that are into cosmetics, and you're selling cosmetics, then you're gonna do well. So my whole thing is, know your audience. Go to your insights, look to see who your audience is, their age range, and also, you know, like where they live. That may have a factor on what you're selling. Where they live, what are they interested in that age range? And I'm gonna show you how you can figure out who your followers are. Okay, so you're going to Instagram, you're gonna click insights. It's gonna be directly on your front screen, or if you don't see it on your front screen, click the three bars and click insights. And then you're gonna click audience. So it's gonna tell you like your growth, the top locations that you are hitting, your age range, and also the gender. And lastly, like when are they online? So when I say know your audience, know like I have 94% women, 6% men. So I need to generate most of my products to be to women. For the 6% men, maybe they like women products, but have some type of unisex products. But this is what I mean by know your audience, know their age ranges, know when they are online. That I'm gonna get into that again, but this tells you about your audience. So the very first tip that I have, besides knowing your audience, my very first tip is to post quality photos. When I say post quality photos, I mean photos that are clear, they're bright, you can clearly see what the person is selling, you can read it clearly, it's not dull or dim. Whether it be you get a light box and you take photos on your light box, or you could also use your surroundings. So if you would like to purchase a light box, it's not necessary at all, because I don't even have one myself. I wanted one, but I never got one. But if you wanted to purchase a light box, there are tons of light boxes on Amazon that start at like $15. You don't have to get a really expensive light box. You can get a $15 light box that comes with the lights and the backgrounds, so you could take very clear photos. Because one thing that people love are clear, aesthetically pleasing photos. Like, it's gonna catch your eye. If you're scrolling on Instagram or Facebook and you see like a really nice product, it's clear, it's pretty, you're gonna click on it, right? Or you're gonna like it. Like, people love aesthetically pleasing photos. If you don't have a light box or don't wanna get a light box, you can also take photos against like backgrounds like this. Like, maybe you have curtains that are nice. This is a backdrop that I brought from Amazon. They have tons on there as well. I'll link this one down. You could take photos against a backdrop, curtains, a comforter. If you have a really pretty comforter, people also use like the silk fabric. Let me grab it really quick. People also use silk fabric like this, and they take pictures on. You can get this from like any fabric store, like Joann's, Hobby Lobby. I don't know if Hallmark sells fabrics, but get you some really nice, like a silk fabric, and you could take lots of pictures, like scrunch it up, and you're good to go. And if you don't like the silk, you could do velvet. But if you wanna use your surroundings and don't spend any money, you can also use the outside. outside nature pictures are amazing. I see those get a lot of traffic. They're just so good to look at. I take some pictures, like most of my pictures are taken on my balcony. If you have a patio or a balcony, or if you have a house and you have like a really nice yard or a lake in the back of your apartments, just use your surroundings and take very clear photos, because that is what's gonna grab the person's attention. So the second tip that I have to tell you all is that you need to be posting at minimum 2 to 3 times a day. I say 2 to 3 times a day minimum because you want your post to show up on your followers' feeds, post to show up on either your feed for your followers or on the hashtags feed that they show. So when you post at least once a day, you're not getting the reach. If you're competing against however many people that you have, they're most likely going to put the most popular photo at the top of the page, and then yours may go all the way to the bottom, or they only show it to a few people. The best thing that you can do is post multiple times a day. That way you'll have different posts on the feed, you'll get seen more, and then not on top of just being seen more, but you'll have more engagement. So the more engagement you have, the more followers you go, and it's just basically like a train, like, you get it, y'all. The next thing, to use hashtags. You want to use hashtags on all of your photos. Like, you do not want to post a photo without posting a hashtag. You want to hashtag every single thing that you post. And I say this because hashtags get your photos seen. I said that hashtags are seen on the main feed on your homepage. If a person doesn't follow you, but they follow the hashtag, for example, lip gloss boss, you put lip gloss boss on your post that you just posted, they may not follow you, but they will still see your picture. Now, I don't know the algorithm. I know people have their own whatever with the algorithm, but your post is going to eventually get seen on someone's page, even if they don't follow you. I see posts all the time from people that I don't even follow on my homepage. And it's just because simply that I am following those hashtags, I see their posts. And then the more hashtags that you use, the better. You want to use a good bit of hashtags that are relatable to your content. And when I say relatable, I mean like down to the T. Like if you're posting a lip gloss filling video, lip gloss filling video, lip gloss filling, like lip gloss queens. Okay, so you want to post hashtags that are relatively like small or medium. If you're trying to get your page discovered, you're just starting out, you don't have that much of a following, or if you have like a moderate following, I say 1,000 or under, or maybe even up to 3,000, you want to use smaller hashtags, meaning they have under 1,000 posts or at least under 5,000 posts. So that will help to get your posts seen more as well. If you're using hashtags that are like 100K posts or 500K posts or even like in the millions, your posts are never going to get seen. Like, I'm sorry, but they just aren't. Because if 3 million people are posting under that same hashtag and they already have their top posts that are like A1, yours is just going to get pushed all the way to the bottom. It's not going to be good. Use like smaller to medium hashtags. Once you gain more and, you know, you're getting a little bit higher in the following and you're posting very, very great pictures or whatever, you can start using your bigger hashtags. So the next tip that I have for you all is to post different types of content. So you can post pictures, of course, like that's what Instagram's for pictures. But you also want to do different types of posts, such as videos, boomerangs, TikToks, and even posting on your Instagram story. These are great ways to get your followers more engaged with your content. If you post videos, like they have something to look at, to watch, especially if it's something really nice. So if you're filling lip gloss tubes, people love those videos. Like, people love lip gloss filling videos, tube filling videos, ASMR. Like, they love those videos, okay? So if you post a video like that, you use the right hashtags, your video is going to get views. And it's okay if it only gets about, what, 500 starting out, or, you know, less. it doesn't matter, because if it's a great video, it's very clear, it has the right lighting, your posts are going to get seen. So you want to do different types of posts, because yes, everyone loves pictures, but no one wants to see pictures all the time. You know, unless they're like bomb and they're different backgrounds, you know, different areas, but you want to switch it up. I said TikToks as well, because TikTok is really trending right now and people are loving to see TikTok videos. Not only is it a video, you can add effects to it and you can also add music to it. So those are two great things that will catch someone's eye when viewing your posts. So that's a great way to gain traction as well. And I'm going to show you the post that basically went viral and blew me up on Instagram. Let's get into these boomerangs and Instagram stories. So the boomerangs is basically a Instagram install feature where it's like a video, but it bounces back and forth, so you can do different things with it. So if you post like a boomerang of like a product, you'll like do whatever, zoom in, move it sideways or whatever, and it'll bounce back and forth. So it's still a video, it's not as long, but you'll still get views. The more views you get, the more likes you get, Instagram is going to push your post on the home page and eventually push your post on the explore page as well. So using Instagram stories is very helpful, because not only do you get your views, of course, but you can also get great engagement if you use stories the right way. When I say use stories the right way, I mean using polls on your stories, asking questions to your followers, doing quizzes, and just doing simple things. Things like that gets people engaged with you. It makes it seem like you're actually interested in your followers, that you're not just trying to sell a product to make money. You're actually trying to get to know them, get to know their interests. You can have a poll on what do someone want to see in your store, or if you're stuck, you don't know what to bring, do you all like this or that? You know, there's the possibilities are endless. So polls are great. You can ask questions, like ask your followers questions, or you can have them ask you questions. Ask them about their week, what they're doing for the weekend, what are their plans for summer. Y'all, it's literally endless. Do questions. You can also do quizzes and like make it fun. There's so many things that you could do to stories. So literally all you have to do is go to Instagram, and I'm just gonna like click that. You're going to click the smiley face sticker, and then you have it. You have products. So if you take a picture of a product, you can add all of your product. You can add your location. You can mention somebody. Like it's so much. You can do a countdown. So say you're about to release a new product, have a countdown on your story, and then people can also join your countdown. Meaning as soon as your countdown ends, they will be notified. They'll want to shop with you. Like, they'll be notified, it'll take them right to it, take them to your page. Great. Challenges, like, you know, there's so much that you can do on Instagram stories, polls, questions, quizzes. Like, there's so much that you can do. That's a great way to engage as well. Our fifth tip is going to go back to the insights, and that's to see your audience insights, because your audience plays a major role in helping you reach your engagement, help you get discovered, etc. You want to go to your audience tab, and you want to see like when are your followers online. So today's Monday, and then it tells you literally time for time. Well, it tells you in 3-hour increments, but it tells you the best times that your followers are the most active on social media. When you post your pictures or videos or what have you, you want to post according to the schedule. So it doesn't always have to be at 12 or at 3 or at 6. You can do like 3:30 or 6:30. But if you see that right now on Mondays, my followers are the most active at 3 p.m., I'm going to post anywhere around 3 p.m. because that's when the most people are online and will see my posts. You feel me? So if you post when people are online the most, or when, you know, a good bit of your following is online, more people will see your post. It wouldn't make sense for me to post at 9 a.m. because, I mean, yeah, almost like 2,500 people are online, but it may not get seen that much. And then by the time 12 comes, when another 1,000 becomes online, my post may be pushed down by other people's posts. You see what I'm saying? So you want to post when your followers are online, okay? You want to post when they're online. Also, while we're on the insights tabs, I just want to show you that Instagram will show you your growth for the week. So it will show you your whole growth, how many people followed you, how many people unfollowed you, and then like your overall growth, what did you get? And you can click by each day to see like the metrics for that day. So I get a lot of follows and then I get a good bit of unfollows, but I mean, it kind of evens out because, you know, so that's another thing that you want to look at and see when your audience is online. That way you'll get more reach. But my next tip is to have giveaways and sales. Now, you do not want to do this all the time, because if you do this all the time, your followers, or you know, the people that look at your page, they're going to expect you to have a giveaway or a sale, and they're only going to begin to purchase or participate and interact with you when you only do those things. So you want to do it every now and again. When you reach like milestone numbers, like say you hit 500 followers or 1K followers, that's a big milestone. If you hit 1K, 5K, 10K, etc., or you know, whatever you feel comfortable with, but have giveaways and don't do anything like big. Do, you know, something as, you know, you'll feel comfortable giving away, like something that's relatively lower in price. So that way you're still giving away something and people still interact. Set some rules to your giveaways, so you know they have to like your posts, they have to follow you, and they must tag 3 or 4 friends. So that way, the more people that interact with your giveaway, they're going to be liking it, so engagement is going to go up on that post, and it may or may not, you know, Instagram's crazy, but it may get shown on Explore. But if they tag their friends are going to look like, what did so-and-so tag me in? So they're gonna click on the post and see what's a giveaway. They may click on your page, and then if they like your page or like what you offer, they may follow you. So you see what I'm saying? You get an engagement with your post, but you may also potentially get new followers and sales. So giveaways are also great. If you have the followers and you're just not making that many sales, you could have a sale Friday special or any day of the week special. Have sales during holidays. Like when a holiday is coming up, you want to go ahead and have a sale. You don't have to, but you want to be having a sale, because most people are going to be having a sale, of course. And if you're not doing good with sales at the time, that'd be a great opportunity for you to get more sales. So if you're having a sale, more people will feel more comfortable buying your product if they didn't want to before, and it's a ripple effect. So sales are great. I just don't recommend doing them too often, because people will only shop, like literally, if they don't like your prices, people will only shop with you when you have a sale, and you do not want that, because you always have to put a sale on. Like, you're diminishing the value of your product, so you don't always want to have a sale. The next tip that I have is to interact with other accounts. So when I say interact with other accounts, that means like liking other accounts. I do not at all mean self-promote under other accounts. Do not go under another lip gloss business, if you're in a lip gloss business, and comment, hey, I'm starting out, follow me, or I have cheap prices, or I have affordable products as well, follow me. Don't do that. That's so disrespectful. Like, y'all, if I had a dollar every time I seen somebody do that on someone's page, it's not cool. Especially to your fellow business owners, even if you don't know the person. It's not cool, because what you're doing is intentionally trying to steal their audience, their customers, and bring them to your page. You know, it's just not cool. There's ways that you can promote yourself without even promoting yourself. Yes, I said it. But don't intentionally promote yourself under someone else's post. Like, it's not cool. And 9 times out of 10, I know I do it, but a lot of other people I know, they're most likely going to delete your comment. If they really don't like stuff like that, they may block you. So you want to really be careful, especially if you don't mean any harm by it. Like, you want to be careful and you just don't want to do that. But interact with other accounts. Put hard eyes under a picture. If you love the picture, comment under it, you know? Also, share posts to your story. It's great interactions. Like, people love that. Maybe you're sharing something that someone hasn't seen, you know? So interact with other accounts. And you also want to interact with other accounts before you post, because if Instagram sees that you're interacting with others, right before you post, like say 15 or 20 minutes before, they're gonna push your posts. And also interacting with other accounts like helps Instagram know that you're not a spam account. So, you know, like those bot accounts that just follow thousands of people and they don't like anything, like they don't, they're just there. There's bots, spam accounts. You don't wanna be seen as a spam account in the eyes of Instagram, because you won't get seen at all. Interact with other accounts and interact with other people that you like. Also, I would say follow other accounts like yours if you want to. You don't have to, but it's also great as well, because it'll show you to maybe their people on Explore. And the more, you know, that the likeness that there is, you can end up on Explore page and, you know, the home page. And, you know, it's just really just a ripple effect with Instagram. Like, I'm telling y'all, it's a ripple effect. But that's all the tips that I have right now. I'm gonna show you guys a post that went viral on Instagram. So I made a TikTok of me like just stirring my lip oil. Well, stirring the lip oil, it was like an ASMR, like you can hear it. Okay, so this is the post that went viral. Well, you can't hear it, but basically I'm just stirring it. And then not only is it like an ASMR video, but the color is very bright, it's very pretty. And it was just like a great video. So this video now, it has 21K views. But when I first posted, like it blew up, like within a few hours. I should have took a picture, but it had so many views. But as y'all can see now, this video has reached 42,000 people. Like, come on. 42,000 people saw my video, 2,000 liked it, 1,000 visited my profile. You know, like these videos get you engagement. So, I mean, look, just look at the insights. Look how many people follow me. 139 people followed me. It was seen by 21,000 people on Explore page. So once the video started reaching so many people and had so much engagement, Instagram put my video on the Explore page. And not only did they put my video on the Explore page, it reached 21,000 more people just from being on the Explore page. So you see what I'm saying? Like, if you have great videos, you're gonna get pushed, you know, to the wider outlets, and you're going to get reach. So let's click one of the hashtags. See, I have my hashtags, and they're all relative to the video. So ASMR lip gloss, ASMR mixing, lip oils, lip gloss vendor, glossy lips, like have hashtags similar to that to reach people. So, oh no, don't click that. I wanna click, oh well, it's not clicking it. But basically, like, my video is like on the top of these hashtags. And look, the hashtag only has 1,000 posts. So, you know, the better that your videos are, the, you know, the more reach that it would get on the hashtag. So when people click the hashtag, they may see your post. Maybe the first post, like you never know. So this went viral on April 18th. So once you have the ball, you want to keep it rolling. So I was like, hold up, this video went viral. Let me post another one. So y'all, I posted this April 19th now. This video of me making my rose oil, and as you can see, it has 35,000 views. Like, y'all, I used hashtags with it as well. This one I used a lot more hashtags so it could push it onto more people. And look at the insights. It reached 65,000 people to date, 3,000 likes, like 178 people clicked my website just off of this video. So which that mean? People click your website, they're gonna view your products, they like it, they're gonna buy it. Come on, it's foolproof. 1K people visit my profile, 44,000 people, what is that? I don't know. 44,000 people from Explore page saw the video. So I was like, you know what? This is amazing. This is amazing. So let's try this again. So yes. I posted 6 days later, I posted this video of the princess lip oil, kind of the same concept, but I actually showed me filling the tubes that it was in. Went crazy. It had great music on it as well. A lot of hashtags. And as you can see, oops, it has 59,000 views. What am I doing? Why am I doing that? It has 59,000 views. It has reached 86K people. And like, y'all, I'm telling you, like, look at the reach, 500 people followed me from this one video. And I'm gonna put my insights for that whole week from the 18th through whatever the week and the day is right here. You see my insights for the week before, when I didn't have that video up, they were lower. After that video was up, my insights went crazy. And then my insights continued to go up throughout the days because of that video, because more and more people kept seeing it, kept seeing it, kept seeing it. So once you have the ball, you want to keep the ball rolling, because why lose it? If you know if you believe in prayer, pray as well, and also manifest everything that you want. And you also want to think positive, like have positive thoughts, because you never know when it's your time to pop. I started my Instagram December 19th, 2019, and that video went viral April 18th, so 4 months in. If I would have quit in March because I wasn't getting sales that much, or I wasn't getting that much engagement, I would have never seen it go viral. I would have never seen 10K followers. I would have never seen sending out almost 500 orders, like, you know? So stay committed, stay positive, and you never know when it's your time to pop. They're just showing my engagements from after those videos went viral and how my engagements went up and my following went up. And yeah, that's pretty much it. So as always, thank you all for watching it. If you made it this far, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe if you have not already, y'all. Like, I'm gonna be giving y'all some gems. So subscribe. Have any questions, you know, anything y'all could think of or suggestions, put them down in the comment box and I'll be reading them. I'll be commenting back. And until the next video. Hey guys, I just wanted to add in that during this time that everything went viral and my engagement went up, I did not use any Instagram paid advertisements. All of this growth was completely organic and, like I said, due to those three videos going viral. So anything is possible. You just have to stay committed and keep going. Pray and manifest. I love y'all.